Good morning, children. So welcome to our class. Today we'll be continuing with the same chapter, the chapter propositional logic. So in our previous lesson we have discussed about the different connectives. I hope you have understood the connectives, different types of connectives, conjunction, disjunctions, negations, implications, equivalence. So all that I have explained you. Today I will be constructing a truth table from the examples and I will explain you how it is used for finding the So the first example which I will discuss where we will apply the connectives is this one. We will construct a truth table. Construct the truth table on for the expression A. You must be knowing this symbol A plus B whole square. Now, for this expression, this is called the expression. So expressions, we will have to make a truth table and we have to get this output. Now the first, before that, we have to make a truth table. So the expression, so you must be knowing the expression, that is two statements are there, A and B, A and A or B. So we just have to write the first two terms. This is A, this is B. So here these are the two propositions or two statements. Two statements using the connectives we are making the assumptions. Now A and B. So another is, now in second one we have to write, we have to break the expressions A plus B. After that we have to see A and A plus B. So this is our truth table. Now truth table, truth table is nothing, it is the combination of true and false in the, suppose this two are statement. So how many true and false we have? Suppose the first statement is false, second statement is false. So both the statement are false. Statement A is false, statement B is false. Second one, second statement is false and, sorry, second statement, first statement is false and second statement is true. Third one, first statement is true and second statement is false. And the fourth one, both are true. Now four terms are there. So when we there, so zero denotes false and one denotes true. Okay. So this is a true and false statement. So in the true statement, both are true, both are false, one false, another true. The first statement false, second statement true, and both are true. So these are the conditions of true and false statement. So now we have to use this expression. So you know about the disjunction operator. Disjunction operator is also called OR operators. You must be knowing the symbol also. OR means, this means OR. OR, it may be represented by the plus sign. So here we have to build the expression. So that means OR expressions we have to build. So in the OR expressions, any one condition should be true. So here both the conditions are false. So it returns 0. Here any one condition true, then it is true. Here one condition true, it is true. Both the conditions are true, that is not true. That is, if the both conditions are true, then we can write. So this is the, now this is the expression A or B. That means truth table of A and B is, if both are false, no return. If any one is true, then true value, true true value, and if both are true, that is true value. So this is the expression. Now second expression. Now we have to make this A and A plus B. This is A and this is A plus B. Now we need to compare this statement, this two statement. If here we are using the AND connectives. Here we are using the AND connectives. AND connectives is also called conjunction. It is also called conjunction. The symbol may be like this, or it may be represented by the dot. So if we do that, let's see the AND connectives. So AND connectives, what is the truth table of AND? What is the conditions for the set two statements? Now see, here this is, both are false, so it is false. Here one is true, one is false, another is true, so it is false. Here this is true, then both the conditions are true. Both the conditions are true, that means it is true. The condition is satisfied. Here both the conditions are true, the condition is satisfied. So this is the truth table of expression A and A plus B. So this now here in this case A is equivalent to A dot A plus B. So this and this are identical, and A is equivalent to A plus B. So given expression, in the given expression A and A plus B is equivalent to this. So this, okay. So this is the truth table to represent the expression. So I have understood, we have used the AND operators and OR operators. AND connectives are operators. Now let us do the second example. Second example, okay, using the truth table, prove that P equivalent, P implies Q is equivalent to Q implies P. Negation Q implies negation P. So we just have to prove that these two statements are the same. So equivalence means if you have the same truth value under every interpretation, it is called equivalence. So if you get the same zeros and one combination, both in this both that one, that means it will prove. Now see, let us break the expression. Two values are there, P and Q. So we have to make a truth table. Expression P and Q are there. P and Q are there. Then the expression which we need is negation Q and negation P. Negation, this symbol is the negation symbol. Negation, that means reverse. Reverse, opposite. If this is, if Q is 0, then it should be 1. If P is 1, it should be 0. So that means opposite of the given statement. Today it's raining. If the statement P is, today it is raining, then negation P will be the statement, today it is not raining. So we are representing the statement or proposition in the alphabets in order to make the expressions. Now let us make this. Now two statements are there, so let us see the combinations, how many terms will come. So first term, first condition is that both the statement might be false. The second condition, first statement being false, second statement being true. Third one, first statement is true, second statement is false. These are the different combinations which we can do. And the last one is both may be true. Now this is the statement. Now negation Q. Negation Q means reverse of Q. Negation Q means reverse of Q. Now this negation means if it is 0, it will be 1. If it is 1, it will be 0. If it is 0, it will be 1, and if it is 1, it will be 0. So this is the negation. Now negation P means you can give dash also. When you have to represent where dash is, instead of this one, you can give dash also. Okay? This expression can also be dash, and this will represent the negation. Negation P means if the value is 0, it will be 1. If it is false, it will be true. If it is true, it will be false. So this will be the one, the statement. Negation Q. Negation 1, 0. Negation P. Okay. Now the expressions which we need is this one. So Q employs P. Now employs truth table you must be knowing. So what will be the truth table of employs? I just write it down. So implication truth table means like this. Suppose two statements are there, P and Q. P implies Q means generally what? So the value, false true value, true false value, and both true value. So these are the four conditions. Now implication means if then else. So if the first statement is false, the second statement might be true or false, it will return the true statement. Now if the first statement is false, then the second statement must be, if the first statement is true, the second statement must be true. So it's false, it will return 0, and this will be the thing. This will be the truth table of the implications. Now we have to find the implication. Q implies negative Q, negation Q implies negation P. Now see the combination. So this is the combination. If first condition is true, second condition is true, it will return the true value. If the first condition is false and returns the true value, it will also return the true value. If the first condition is false and the second condition is false, that means it will return the false value. And if both the first condition is true, false, and second condition is true, then it will return the same value. So this is the expression. So we can prove that here it is this column here, column P implies Q and negation of Q implies negation P are identical, so the expression is equivalent. So this is true. Okay, so these are identical. So this expression, one more expression I have to make now. This one, P employs, you see, So p plus q means this one. 0 is 0, this is 0. Means first statement is false, second statement be anything, it will return 1. This one, 1, this will be 1. And this one, first one, second false, this will be 0. And 1, this will be 0. So these two statements are identical. So this, so this, this one is true and it is. Expression is equivalent. Equivalent. So this is the solution. Now I'll just give one last one, that is equivalence. Equivalence. Equivalence we have not done. Now the last part I will be doing, truth table, that is prove that P equivalence to Q is Q equivalence to P. So example, prove that P equivalence, this is not, this is biconditional statement. Implication is the conditional statement and equivalence is the biconditional statement. Let's do Q equivalence to. So we make one truth table. So I do know what make a truth table now. So two expressions is there, P and Q are two statements. So P statement is two statement, different conditions there. If the first statement is false, second statement might be maybe false, false. Maybe the second condition, if first statement is false, second statement might be true. Third condition, if the first condition is true, second condition might be false, or both may be true. Now I need to prove this P implication and also I have to build the expression Q implication. Okay. Now you know the implication connectives. Implication connective is also called biconditional. So let me make one table, two tables for if and only if, that is biconditional. So this is P, so biconditional. Now what will be the statement? So P and Q is the statement. P equivalence Q, so capital, means, so both true, one false, another true, first true, second false, and both are true. Now what will be this one? So in this case, if both are false, then it will return 1. If both are false, will return 1. If only 1 is true, it will return false. And last one, if both are true, then it returns. So, in the biconditional or equivalence, or if and only if, first condition is true, false, and second condition is false, the result will be true. If the first condition is false, and second condition is true, the result will be false. If the first condition is false and second condition is, if the first condition is true and second condition is false, the result will be false. And if both the conditions are true, it will return the true one. So this is the implication statement. Implication statement. So implication statement, truth table is like that. Based on that, we will be getting this. Now just see that both are false means what will be the value of P implies Q? Sorry, P equivalent Q. What will be the value of P equivalent Q? So 0, 0, both are false, that means it will return the true value. If only one is false, it will return the false value. So this will be the, if only one is true, no? here in this case also 1 will return true. If both the cases are true, it will return the true value. This is P implies Q. Now Q implies, sorry, P equivalent to Q. Now Q equivalent to P. Now this thing, the same only. If both the statements are true, it will return 1. If only 1 is true, then it will return false. Here also only 1, it is false. And if both are true, then it will return 1. So you can say that it has been proved, it is proved that P expression Q, P equivalence Q is equals to P Q valence. So it is proved that P equivalence Q is equals to Q equivalence to K. Okay, so this is the, okay, now these are some of the truth table. Now we just discussed the example 6, so I'll just take one example. So this is the last one where we have to, some proposition is given, you just have to write the, write it in the expression. Now proposition statement, 2.6, let's see. Consider some simple proposition given below. Propositions are there. Proposition A, it is raining. Proposition B, wind is blowing. Proposition C, I am not driving. Now the question is, from this create a compound proposition. Create a compound proposition. So the this proposition, just suppose number one, A, this one. What do you mean by this? A, B. What is the, what do you mean by this? What is the symbol you need to understand now? Second one, question number B, this one. Third one, B dot C. Fourth one, okay, this is this three. Now A, this means what is this symbol? A or B, isn't it? This means or, this is disconjunction connectives. So with the help of the disconjunction connectives, we are making the simple proposition into compound proposition. So if I have to write this expression A or B, then I just have to write A means it is raining. It is raining. Or, so this is or. Or wind is blowing. So or expression. This is the symbol of or expression. Second one, this B. This means negation of B, negative conjunction connectives, the operator is negation operator, opposite of this. So B means what? Wind is blowing. So opposite of this is wind is not blowing. Not operator. Wind is not blowing. Now the third one. This B C. What do you mean by this? This means negation of B and C. Negation of B means opposite of this one. The opposite of this statement is wind is not blowing. And C means I am not driving. So the statement will be negation of B means it is. So statement B, sorry. Statement B is wind is blowing. Expression D, okay. I just change the question. Let me read this A. Not A. Not A means? Not A means not. Negation. Not A means it is not raining. Now this dot operator, this means and operator. This means conjunction operators. This is conjunction connectives. So this and this rain is not, sorry, it is not raining and C means and means C is as it is, C means I am not driving, so it's not a negation, whatever is there I have tried, so I am not driving. So this with the based on the expression, based on this expression WFF, you are writing the statement. So sometimes you have your statement will be given and you need to write an expression. So these are some of the examples on the connectives, truth tables and the propositions, compound proposition and simple proposition. So I want you to go through the examples as well as I want you to try the exercises at the back. So I think we are going to conclude this chapter. In the next chapter, we will be doing the logic gates. Thank you.